Good afternoon, respected GTSer and my dear friends. Today's lecturer topic is string of pearls. So first of all, we have to understand what string of pearls means. Officially, there is no term which is called a string of pearls. It is the term which is made by Indian media. And if we have to understand this word, string of pearls, it generally means that China, which is right now covering India from all sides, whether we can take the example of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and then their ambitious project, that is Road and Belt Initiative, that will connect the Asia, Africa and Europe countries with the maritime and land route. So through this, a kind of ring is covered all around the India. Through this, it is called as the string of pearls. Because if we take the port of Chittagong, port of Bangladesh, then we can take the Hambantota port of Sri Lanka, which is under control of the China, and the Gwadar port also, where they are Chinese are working. So they are making a ring, and their influence in the we can say the Indian Ocean have been increasing. So if I talk about the impact over India, so definitely if the presence of Chinese Navy will increase into the Indian Ocean, definitely there is a threat to the national security of India, sovereignty to India, and definitely India have to increase the surveillance at that place. Now, what is the thing that India can do? First of all, India have to increase the relations between the islands, countries that are present in the Indian Ocean, whether it is Mauritius, Seychelles, Sri Lanka and other small islands that are present there, Maldives. So India have to strengthen their relation with them and make a military base at that place, so that India can make a create a proper surveillance into the Indian Ocean. Apart from that, India is doing a quad exercise with US, Japan and Australia, through which they are taking care of any kind of challenges and situations in the Indian Ocean. And the other thing that India can do is to strengthen its navy, because Chinese navy is quite large compared to India. So India also have to work over the navy and the coast guards, and India have to increase their surveillance into the Indian Ocean so that some kind of critical situation will not happen. Thank you.
A very good afternoon, gentlemen. My today's lecture topic is the string of pearls. So in this lecture, I will talk about the string of pearls and how India can counter it through the Iron Curtain strategy. So gentlemen, as we know that China's string of pearls is a strategic move to cordon India through the naval front in the Indian Ocean region. We know that China is always assertive in nature. In the 1971, during when the war was going on between India and Pakistan, then India warned China not to interfere, otherwise it will block the Strait of Malacca, through which we know that China import 90% of its crude oil and other things. So it will hamper the entire Chinese economy. So therefore, and also China knew that India is having very geographically very strong navy in the Indian Ocean region and near the Strait of Malacca. So China made a secret strategy to make naval bases to cordon India Indian Ocean region, and that is the string of pearls. Now we need to know that what progress China did throughout this year. So China got access in the Bangladesh port. China, we know that China is having Hambantota port of Sri Lanka take lease for 99 years. Then China is having military naval access in the Maldives. China is also having military bases in Djibouti. It also having a very important Gwadar port in Pakistan and many more. So therefore, China is basically trying to cordon India from the south, so that it can cordon India in the true front war. Now, how India can counter it? We know that Also, India's 90% of crude oil and other thing is imported and exported through this Strait of Malacca. So you know that by losing the influence on this region will seriously hamper India's economy. So India also made a strategy that is the Iron Curtain strategy to counter China. The first thing is India is having very good relations with the Southeast Asian countries. That is the Modi's ACT-EAST policy. India is also connecting the Northeast to the these Southeast Asian nations through the trilateral highway between Myanmar, Thailand and India. After that, China got the access in the Dakkam port. China got his access in the Chabahar port in Iran. India also trying to convince Singapore for the Changi Naval Base. India also having naval, that is the naval bases in the Vietnam. After that, India is also trying to get more access in the neighboring countries. Like we have a very good pact, we have a quad group, we know we can so, of Australia, USA, Japan and India. We have naval bases in the France, that is the near the Diego Garcia. We have Cocos Island. After that, we also trying to counter China in the South in Indian Ocean, and it is very much important. Finally, I would like to conclude my lecture by saying that definitely we have a lot to do. Like right now, we need to strengthen our Indian Navy in the Indian Ocean region. We need three aircraft carriers. At current situation, also we need to help our neighboring country so that China will not make this country under his death trap. After that, it is very much important to counter China in the naval front because China is having a very good position in the Himalayan. Thank you very much.